Thank you, Rob. This is going to be a fun one tonight. We've been looking forward to the Ducks and the Utes for some time. 15,000 strong, a sold-out Huntsman Center here in Salt Lake City. The Oregon Ducks, the number 10 team in the country, one of the unbeatens at the top in Utah right now. On the outside, look into Arizona and Oregon. Welcome courtside, Aaron Goldsmith alongside Coach Steve Lavin. And Lav, as we begin to flip the calendar over to February, a lot on the line for both teams.
Well, if you're Oregon, Dana Altman has the Ducks once again in the midst of a record-breaking season. They're fighting for a championship in the Pac-12 and also looking at a one seed if they can finish strong. The Utes, they're on the flip side. They need to build their resume. This is an opportunity for a key signature win on their home court against the Ducks.
Ducks have won a program record 16 straight. Jordan Bell leading the conference in field goal percentage for the running Utes. Lorenzo Bonham leading Utah in points, assists, and steals. And, of course, the big storylines today, that man right there, David Collette, out the last two games as he has had the resurgence of symptoms from a concussion suffered in practice. On the other side, Dylan Brooks, offseason foot surgery, missed the last game, was in a walking boot, has been cleared to play. So the big difference makers on both sides in the starting lineups for the Ducks and the Utes as Oregon crawls.
Dana Altman and Coach Krestoviak, two of the best at peaking their teams this time of the year, the early turnover. Here comes Daniels.
That was a problem against Stanford. Collette and the paint. He has been such a force, a midseason transfer out of Utah State, double figures in all nine games since gaining eligibility.
And the Utes in the zone defense here are going to try and level off the ability of the Ducks to penetrate the ball.
Good pass. Dylan Brooks, easy in the paint.
Well, and that's textbook execution. The ability to get the ball to the short corner and then pocket pass on the interior of that Ute zone defense.
So the two guys that were questionable, game time decisions, both with early buckets on both sides. Bonham has been even better than usual against four ranked opponents this year, averaging 17 a game for Utah against the toughest competition this season. Four to shoot. Bonham having a step through. Right to Ennis. Began his career at Rice, transferred to Villanova, missed almost all of last season with a foot injury. Back healthy now, taking it to the rim. And as Collette pulls it down.
Utes will run off their defense and turnovers, but they prefer to play through the paint. Now they dominate opponents in terms of points in the paint as a result. That's using your personnel. The size, the strength, and the length. Also the skill and intelligence that the Utes bigs play with.
Tough shot there, off the mark by Zuma. Bell with Collette on him. Bell using the feet.
Yeah, didn't rush that shot, Aaron. Was able to get his balance and finish. A three-quarter court pressure by the Ducks. They'll give different looks just to keep you off balance. Nice pass on the inside. That's that tandem. Collette to Kuzma. And Larry Krestoviak was a great post player at Montana in the NBA as well. And he schools the big men here at Utah as well as any coach in the country.
Kuzma, six straight double-doubles. Pritchard wants a three from straight away. True freshman out of Lynn, Oregon. And this goes to Utah. We go back to the Jordan Bell bucket.
Well, isolation and single coverage. So he uses the bounce and able to back down, get a high percentage look. And then here again, interior passing, playing in pairs, almost like dancers. The fours and the fives, the front line players here at Utah really have a good sense for one another on the floor.
There's JoJo Zamora, JUCO transfer from Oakland. Daniels coming off a career night against the Huskies of Washington. 24 points, under 10 to shoot now. He takes it off the glass.
He took a page out of Dylan Brooks' book. Even has the same hairdo. Those are both tremendous heads of lettuce. All Pac-12 lettuce head.
Dorsey too strong on the three. Bonham pushing the tempo for the Utes. Taking it in the paint with the left hand off the glass.
see the size of Daniels and Bonham, their ability, the length and strength. A steal by Bonham, again, using that wingspan to get out in transition.
Finishes! Suddenly a six-point lead for Utah early. And this place is alive. Brooks over Collette.
Luke Brooks giving the crowd the Utes fans not happy.
Brooks has been a major nemesis to Utah, averaging over 20 a game in his career versus the running Utes. Bonham backs it out with seven to shoot. Bonham pulls up for the three, short. Dorsey had 23 points and 9 rebounds in the Pac-12 title game against Utah last year as Brooks is too strong and Daniels with the rebound. Knocked away. Here comes Dorsey. Ducks have numbers, 3-on-2. Dorsey can't finish. Zamora with Collette. Collette off the glass.
In the running Utes here early.
What a pass. Bell gets a swatted foul. They call a foul on Collette. He can't believe it. Well, Utah Utes behind this crowd, Steve.
Track meet style. Bonham, little change of pace. Good gather. The left hand off the window. The strength, the length to finish. Utah looking strong early. Big fella gets involved. Collette with the bucket.
This is the second.
Yeah, I think my microphone is missing in action there, Aaron. But picking up from where I left off, I know the sign language helped you pick right up. But for the viewers, these two coaches have had success at multiple stops. So it shows a flexibility. Be able to take their blueprint, different leagues, different levels of basketball, different regions of the country, and have success.
Seven to shoot as Bonham tries to direct some traffic with the clock ticking. And the paint slotted away. All 12 points for Utah so far coming in the paint. Dorsey with the chin fake. Gives it up. And Bell draws contact. They wave the basket off and call it on the floor.
Draw help and then make that pocket pass to Bell.
Battles on Kuzma. Boucher is on the floor for the first time for the Ducks. Vincent as well. Good skip pass. Dylan Brooks.
Again, that's the sweet spot. The high post. Great place to operate. You get the ball there. You're well deployed in terms of being able to look to both sides of the floor. Got the nice jump shot there. Can drive it as well.
Brooks with 6 of the first 9 for the Ducks. Dorsey on Daniels. Daniels crosses over. Scoots high. No good. Rebound pulled down. Put back by Kuzma. Vincent penetrates. Kicks. Boucher. Big man can hit from deep, and he does.
Boucher loves those corners for a player his size. Unusual shooting ability, a marksman.
He went 6-for-9 from downtown versus Washington State not long ago. Trying to travel.
Boucher not only a protector of the rim on defense in terms of blocking shots, but how about the luxury Dana Altman has to step him out to the deep corner for bombs away, bottoms of the net.
He attempted 7 threes in their last game, which came at home against Stanford.
And Boucher rarely forces. I'm impressed with his intelligence. Lets the game come to him. And multiple looks here early by Utah. We've seen man-to-man, seen a conventional 2-3 zone, a 1-3-1 zone. Now they're tinkering.
Brooks, a hard take high, and he's able to put it through. How about that scoop?
Wow. How about cupping the ball? And then finishing. Looked like Iceman, George Gervin. You weren't even born.
Now, how do you
when Iceman used to take it to the hole for the finger roll.
8 points for Brooks. As Dana Altman said, Dylan Brooks is our personality, especially on the defensive end. 8 to shoot. Fairfield gives it up. Johnson, no good. Kuzma fighting. Boucher with a block. Dorsey lowers his shoulder, and a foul is called on Utah and Cedric Fairfield.
He's getting physical there at the rim. Dylan Brooks feeling it. Coach Altman giving him the green light. Emerald City, go to work, fella. Off the window one more time. Splitting defenders high off the glass.
We take you back to last March in Las Vegas. Pac-12 Tournament Championship game. Utah number 12, Oregon number 8. And this lap was a total beatdown. Tyler Dorsey led the way, 23 points. Dylan Brooks dropped 18 as well for Oregon, who forced 20 Utah turnovers, which led to 28 points.
Made that dramatic run to the Elite Eight. Cut down the nets in conference and conference tournament play as well. So a banner season for Dana Altman and the Ducks, and they've got their sights on a Final Four this year.
They've won 7 in a row versus the Utes. Boucher launches another 3, this time off the mark.
And keep in mind, Oregon's had their way in recent years with most all Pac-12 teams. Now that's why Dana Altman's had such tremendous success and honors coming his way year after year, and well-deserved.
Rawson on the floor for the first time. And it stays with Utah. Missing the last 2 games. Practicing today in shoot-around, truly for the first time in about a week and a half or 2 weeks.
Well, as a veteran player, he can make the adjustments. That's one of the advantages. The transfer from Utah State brings a maturity, a perspective that's unique.
Once again, milking the shot clock, 5 to shoot. Daniels fades on the baseline.
It's amazing how similar Brooks and Daniels' games are.
Dorsey on the other end, short. Possession stays alive as Benson is able to get it up top. Benson ends up having a wide open finger roll. Tie things back up.
A good maneuvering by Benson there. Alert, and then slammed on the brakes, gathered the feet. Saw that he had an opening, why not?
Cedric Fairfield, the SMU transfer, just a handful of games for the Mustangs. Trying to find his fellow midseason transfer, Collette. Last touch by the Ducks.
An active defense there by Brooks, coming in, extending his arm there to knock that ball away and prevent a catch by Collette.
Dorsey and Brooks to the bench for Dana Altman. Jordan Bell back on the floor. And Pritchard as well. Near the corner, Fairfield launches.
Well-executed out-of-bounds play by the Utes. Fairfield showing his ability from distance.
Benson keeps the dribble alive and now calls for a timeout. Utah leading by 3 against number 10 Oregon. The Ducks bring with them the 3rd longest active winning streak of the nation. Gonzaga at 20 in a row, Kansas with 18. And the Ducks with now a school record 16 consecutive wins.
And that record was set 104 years ago, 1911, 12, and 12-13. Over those 2 seasons combined, they had 15 consecutive wins.
And it's with 2 to shoot. And it's Parker Van Dyke on the floor who controls the loose ball.
Both these teams will play switching man-to-man. They'll play various zone defenses and, of course, trying to level off dribble penetration, protect the rim, and also give different looks, keep a team out of rhythm offensively.
Collette with Bell on him. is able to draw the foul. First foul against Oregon.
Yeah, a little Bronx cheer here in Salt Lake City. Out of their seats. Engaged. Love to see that. Must be rounding towards February.
Van Dyke, a contested three, and he knocks it down. Largest lead of the day for Utah. Ennis with the right hand, fouled and through.
Some of the defenses here. Ennis able to maneuver off the bounce. The transfer from Villanova, former Big East athlete, now out west with the Ducks and Eugene. Good lift, but also attacking off the bounce. Purposeful bounce, Aaron. A very effective weapon against the zone.
Can't convert the three-point play. Ennis averaged 10 points a game his final season with Villanova. Kuzma's had a quiet start to this game.
He's another player that doesn't force, lets the game come to him. He'll pick his spots.
Benson in front of Airfield, front iron this time. Ennis leading the charge for the Ducks. Take it out of the whole Utes team and bottom swats it away.
No easy ones tonight at the rim. Good help. Again, the length, the trees. Fully extended. Just not many easy buckets. They're stout in terms of their size down low.
Well, pretty backdoor pass. Benson, a three, and he hits.
Well, good alert offense by the Ducks there to find the open man. A little hot potato.
Benson 2 games ago, 5 for 5 from behind the arc versus Cal. 8 minutes to go in the first half. No Collette on the floor for the Utes. Bottom taking Keith Smith baseline. He's on the floor for the first time for Oregon. Now 6 to shoot. Van Dyke, chin fake, deep 2.
Good shot fake to lift the defender. Put the Ducks in the popcorn popper and then able to get to the sweet spot.
A rare miss for Bell. The conference's best shooter in terms of pure field goal percentage.
That's a good sign. Two Utes going after the ball aggressively. Another Ute going to the floor. It means your team is ready to go. Alert, aggressive. Had this Utes team earlier this year a few times, and they are much improved. Not just because of the newcomers, but across the board, this unit playing well together.
With one to shoot. It's knocked free and a shot clock violation.
Care if they're man or zone, you guys can run a man play. I'd be happy if you run horns. I don't want to be down here having to call things, but we need players to make plays. Okay? You know what I'm talking about down there? You guys are like in a 30-second delay, what you do at the end of a clock. And you don't need to... Hey, Coos. Coos. You don't need to just make something up all of a sudden and attack. Okay? 4 points.
Players understand, making a point, he's emphatic, in particular against Oregon's changing defenses. He wants them to play concept basketball, to read and react. At this stage of the season, your team has the right basketball habits. So instead of trying to back it out with the clock running down and try and run something different versus zone or man, just keep the ball moving. Look for high post touches and look to set screens. Find the opening.
Kuzma pivots his way to the rim but can't finish.
I think it's great that the play has been physical in the lane, in the paint, and the officials, for the most part, are letting them play.
First 12 points for Utah coming in the paint. 10 of the next 12 outside. Pritchard puts on the brakes, a 360 and kisses it in.
We've seen that on multiple possessions by the Ducks. Get in tight, jump stop, get your feet, get organized, and as you said, he pivoted to find daylight for the easy bucket. That's back to habits. You get into traffic, you want to be on balance, be quick, but don't hurry.
Makes it now 1 point game with under 8 to shoot for the Utes. 5 to shoot. Bottom, a Curry 3, too strong. Gets it right back, extends the possession.
Kuzma may need to step up in terms of asserting himself, aggressiveness, not forcing.
Foul is on Tyler Dorsey, only the second team foul for Oregon. Kuzma takes a three. And it's able to touch every inch of the rim.
That's important. Not the force, but on catches. Kuzma, a gifted player. Don't want to guard yourself. You have to make the defense play you on. They're going to back off you. Knock it down.
Bell going up against Collette off the window.
Both these teams have found a nice offensive rhythm. Sharing the ball, not forcing.
And Dyke almost out of bounds. Desperation to Kuzma. Now Daniels. And a foul on Pritchard.
Well, Kuzma has improved from year to year with the Utes. Good lift. I like the pronation of the wrist. The ball rolls off those middle three fingers. A very soft touch here. Bell with the back down into the lane.
Bell had made 24 of his last 29 shots entering this one tonight.
Well-coached teams are on balance more frequently than not. And these teams, when they take the majority of their shots, they are on balance. Got their feet under them, square to the basket.
Collette short corner. Higby Williams on the floor trying to contest, but Collette goes right over the top. Collette with six now.
Christmas came early for the Utes when they picked up David Collette and Cedric Bearfield, two transfers.
Some handles from Pritchard. Bell, baseline, and a foul on Kuzma. That's his second. Two games ago, a career best 26 points on 11 for 12 shooting versus Cal.
Bell also played for the Compton Magic. He's really stepped up his aggressiveness in this game in particular on his catches. Looking to be a threat, but still making good reads in terms of judgments.
A foul sends this to the other direction.
To set a down screen here for Van Dyke. And may have leaned somewhat with that shoulder.
Brooks got off to a hot start, 8 points, takes a deep two, and he buries. He's in double figures.
So comfortable at the top of the floor on his catches. Again, a three-quarter court pressed by the Ducks.
And a foul going against Brooks, his first. A major problem for Utah.
Well, the confidence, the nice step back, which creates some separation or distance between himself and Daniels. And that's all Brooks needs. He had a game winner, as we know, against UCLA and a dramatic victory up in Eugene on Matthew Knight Court.
That's the last close game the Ducks have played. Everything else blowout wins by at least 20 points.
When you look at their numbers in Pac-12 conference play, and they're just solid across the board. Every statistical category, and that's why they've dominated.
Bell strips it to Brooks, or should I say by an average of 20 points, those blowout wins. Scraping past Stanford by 17 the last time out. Brooks up top going nowhere as Bell throws a bullet and saves it.
Wow.
How did he get to that? Eight to shoot. Brooks tucks to Boucher, hunting his second three. And Dylan Brooks whistled for the foul as he went over the top of Jace Johnson. For Brooks, his second.
Utah, the best defensive rebounding team in the Pac-12 during conference games. And again, it goes back to Coach Kostowiak. An excellent big man himself, understands post-play, teaches it. What we saw in that timeout, his ability to give instruction.
Now, Lab, what do you make of this? Dana Altman staying with Dylan Brooks with two fouls. We've seen, of course, Kostowiak going to the bench with Kuzma and Collette when they've got a two fouls.
Yeah, it's a feel. You see Johnson down low, able to draw the foul. He's also evaluating the time and the score. Can he buy some time if he has a lead by going to the bench for a conference title? as Oregon is, and you have your sights set on the Final Four and a number one seed. It's what they want to position themselves for. You might roll with your better players on the road in an environment like this.
First free throw attempts this half by the Utes, and Johnson misses both. Bell, by the way, to the bench. You saw Dorsey come on. Bell with two fouls. Brooks, a game-high 10 points. Puts it on the deck and kicks. Boucher keeps going after that three. Made the first, has missed since.
That's Dana Altman looking at his personnel and putting players in position where they can be successful. Boucher is actually more comfortable facing the basket than he is with his back to the basket. So invert your offense, allow your guards to play, make it catches in the post, and step your bigs away, European style.
Under 90 seconds. Utah by one here in the first half. Bottom throws it right to Ennis.
Boy, Ennis again.
Upstairs, Boucher!
That's pretty basketball. Dylan Brooks with that spin move, but stays on balance. And Boucher, a nice cut from the corner there to catch it and jam it home.
An emphatic way for the Ducks to take the lead. Their first since the 17-53 mark. Utah came out with tons of momentum earlier, and all of a sudden, it's the Ducks on top.
Yeah, dribble weave into the little spin move and the dish. You know, the NCAA Select Committee talks about the optics, the eye test. Just sitting courtside with you here, watching these two teams play, they're both clearly NCAA tournament caliber. We know with Oregon, the possible one seed, but Utah as well, a team that could win games in the tournament.
Well, he's been treated to a heck of a first half, as has everybody else, as Johnson ties it up.
And there's Dan Gavitt, worked for years in the Big East, was actually a basketball coach at one point at Providence. Of course, the son of Dave Gavitt, one of the great visionaries in the history of basketball. And is a heck of a coach and a broadcaster. Dave Gavitt had the triple crown going there, the triple threat, a little like you. I think at some point you could still end up coaching.
Well, only with your assistance now. Under 10 to shoot. Brooks with Johnson in front of him, and Brooks is having himself a half. A game best 13.
At peace with his game. Let's see if Utah goes with a high pick and roll or just flattens the defense.
5 seconds. Bottom able to stay with it, trying to find Johnson. Boucher comes up, and he'll just tuck it.
At peace with his game, why he's a first-team All-American candidate, a Player of the Year candidate, just sizes up, a little jab step, and lifts the ball to the clouds. A nice rainbow.
Ducks trying to extend their program-best 16-game winning streak, the third longest active winning streak of the nation right now. They lead it by two. Both teams shooting over 50%. Dylan Brooks, a sensational first half. Kyle Kuzma trying to get things going, looking for his seventh straight double-double. Aaron Goldsmith alongside Coach Steve Lavin. And Lavin, the big question for the Ducks: would Dylan Brooks be ready to go today? His sprained foot, missed the last game versus Stanford. He's 6-for-7 shooting.
Yeah, he's completely at peace, playing with confidence. And give Dana Altman credit for deploying a player with the versatility Brooks has in a proper manner. We've seen him with the mid-range jumper, good flexion in the wrist on that shot. Here, playmaking over the top to his partner Boucher for the dunk. And here, a tough shot high off the box. And again, just sizing up, a jab step in rhythm, torching or tickling the twine from all angles, Aaron. And again, he has that Swiss Army knife versatility. Formation is associated more with the foot, where I think flexion in the wrist may be more apropos.
The Ducks start the second half with the lead. They led for all of a minute in the first half. Bottom launching right away. Short. And it stays with the Utes.
Both these teams would be wise to attack the paint through the bounce, but also through post feeds. Look to get touches in the interior. Play inside out. Doesn't mean, again, you have to force it inside, but
Daniels left his feet really without a good option. And it goes to Oregon. Lab, what do you make of the fact that at halftime this is a 33-31 game, so low-scoring affair, and yet both these teams shooting over 50%?
Well, they're well-coached. and they're well prepared. And it's a significant game in terms of how meaningful at this stage of conference play and even looking ahead to the NCAA tournament. And these teams run good offense in terms of shot selection, good take from the elbow, an isolation move there. And Brooks able to finish. He is a difficult matchup. And again, the Ducks move him around the floor so he gets catches in different areas where he can attack.
Now Brooks, for his career, 5-0 against Utah, shooting about 60% as Collette answers on the other end.
And Aaron, speaking of good offense, the last two possessions, both Ducks and Utes rewarded by attacking the rim. Brooks off the bounce, and there a post feed to Kuzma, which draws the double and the easy dish for the zero-footer.
Pritchard crossing over, stepping through. Dorsey, who was held scoreless in the first half, gets swatted by Collette, who's fired up. And a foul on Pritchard, trying to reach from behind. That's his third.
Mr. Dorsey's going to have to attack the rim, play over the top if you expect to get fouled against this U team.
Pritchard, the first player on either side with three fouls. Collette, an offensive foul. Prescovia can't believe it. And four.
Just got to make it bang, bang. There may have been a flop, some acting, and yet you have to give credit because he sold it well. Crowd not happy. Prescoviak not happy. Also Collette, because the forearm wasn't. I come from it a little differently. I'm not an official, and the officials are told how to call the games.
A rare miss for Dylan Brooks. So Collette on the bench now. Jace Johnson back on the floor as Collette has three fouls. Zamora puts on the brakes. Kuzma a little bit of a quiet first half, 7 points.
Well, Kuzma has a propensity to pick his spots, in particular late game.
Daniel hits! Foul on the floor. Daniels picks up his first foul.
Well, Daniels again, reminiscent of Brooks, to Brooks, who has greater size, but their style of play very similar. And Ennis able to attack the rim, missed his first chance to make the back end here.
Nearly an 80% free throw shooter on the season.
And going back to your point earlier, as we see a three-quarter court pressure employed here by the Ducks. Just a different look, not allowing Utah to walk into their offense and establish rhythm. But both these teams run good offense, take care of the ball. Utah in conference play under 10 now in terms of turnovers.
Johnson controls it. Dylan Brooks with the rejection. Now a jump ball call. Possession arrow going to Oregon.
It's been fierce, the play in the paint. Dodged a bullet on that possession. And we're hearing it from the Ute fans.
Well, there's no doubt. Dorsey to Bell. Take it on Johnson. Fouled. It counts.
Dorsey, tremendous poise. Plays at the pace. Has the vision and the skill to find Bell on the move. Bell able to catch. Wisely doesn't bring it down. Keeps the ball high. This is a weight room basket, where he puts the shoulder into the sternum of the defender, extends to finish, steps to the line for the old-fashioned three-point play conversion. See, good offense sets your defense when you shoot a free throw.
Daniels able to save him, the right to Benson. Ennis, transition. Bad angle right underneath the rim. Daniels a three from the wing off the mark. Kuzma will be whistled for the foul. Check that, Ennis. He'll figure it out.
Well, far side. 65% of shots taken from one side of the floor. When they miss, go to the far side.
Well, then Sorkin checks in for the first time, taking the spot of Ennis. He's on Kuzma, right out of the gates. Kuzma controls, goes up, forces the foul, and he'll shoot.
They may not be there late in the clock. In other words, don't guard yourself. Or another way of saying is, don't take a good shot, turn it down, and it ends up being a bad play.
Gibson both has nine. We saw Collette. He's on the bench. An early foul to start the second half. He has three. And worth going back for a minute, Lav. Brooks, we thought, had two fouls near the end of the first half. It turns out he had only one. They gave one of those fouls to Peyton Pritchard as Brooks loses.
This is one of the best games I've seen this year, covered a number, coast to coast. And it's because well-coached teams at this stage of the season play a cleaner game. Everything is contested. And, of course, what's at stake, the significance for both teams of such an important game.
And with that in mind, Collette on the bench, as we just covered. Brooks on the bench now for Oregon. Brooks with a game-high 15 points. Chase Johnson fighting for the loose ball and a foul on Fox as we take a look at some top 10 losses in the week. Marquette fined for their students rushing the floor after taking down the defending champs, number one Villanova. Of course, West Virginia, Bob Huggins, that program has had its way, taking down some top seeds. Just one of a handful of top-ranked schools getting drowned. Van Dyke with his second three ball. Utah on top by a pair. Dorsey trying to answer. Boucher under the rim, and a block by Jace Johnson. Loose ball. Bell to Boucher, running the floor. Foul, glass, and through.
Morgan comes out on the right side, fortuitous. Off the mishandle by Bearfield, it leads to conversion. Boucher able to finish using that length, graceful, catch it in stride, didn't have to put it on the deck.
Tied game.
After made baskets and free throws, Oregon will give different looks here in the full court. It's one thing if the ball goes out of bounds or you travel, because you can set your defense. And an opponent has to come down the floor and score against that set defense. Live ball most often leads in layups and dunks because of the mathematics. A three-on-two, two-on-one breaks off those live ball turnovers.
Tend to shoot. Kuzma the high screen for Daniels. Kuzma, deep three in front of Brooks. Mike the Bell. Now going back to that block against Boucher, the conference's leading shot blocker. You don't see him on the other end of that very often at all.
No.
Bell reverse two-hand slam.
Wow. He's been working the rim like a pull-up bar tonight. That one reverse.
Bell now with 11.
At this rate, they may have to check the screws on that rim. Might be shaky. Might need to replace it. Another turnover.
To Johnson, Bell with the slot. Dorsey pushing the tempo. No numbers. In transition, Benson launches and buries.
Ducks on a surge here. See if Coach Kostowiak calls a timeout or lets him play. They've been a bit disjointed. All started with Bearfield's turnover in the open court. Ducks went the other way and have been on a run since.
Benson hasn't missed. It was last season he scored a season-best 15 points against the Utes right here in Salt Lake City. Blocking foul on Boucher.
Well, a good two-man game again. Just a breakdown in coverage by the Ducks. And Bell goes reverse for the style points. And then here, blocks the shot. And in transition, the Ducks get out. Opportunistic. They will knock down three balls. Good time to shoot the three in transition.
And it's back on the floor. Bottom short distance.
Well, Utah excellent on baseline out of bounds play. That was good execution. A nice slice to the cup.
And this has taken the spot of Boucher, who exits with three fouls. Brooks wide open, taking a three off the mark. Dorsey controls, going right up against Rawson. Foul, his first.
And when you have those big guards, not only on defense is it helpful, harder to see over the top of a larger defender, a bigger defender with length in terms of finishing at the rim on offense or picking up some offensive boards as Dorsey did here. It's a plus to have that size. Doesn't mean there's not room for the diminutive water bugs, the little road runners, the beat beepers. We need them too, the Tyus Edneys, the Chris Pauls, but a big strong guard, something to be said in college basketball for that.
Kuzma gets Bell up in the air. Giving Ross in space.
Yeah, Dyke's been very productive. See if they go back to him. He's been feeling it tonight.
Kuzma, a three, front iron. Here comes Ennis. Taking on Daniels. And they're calling a foul on Daniels.
Because why was the whistle so late? They may have gotten it right, but when there's the one count, two count, now three count, and you hear that delayed whistle. It was definitely a hard play on the ball. Type of basketball we're playing with tonight.
Coach Krzyzewski told us today at Shooterman that he recruited the man we just saw, Devin Daniels, specifically to guard Oregon's backcourt. He had that in mind when watching Daniels play in high school.
Yeah, when you take a little program as Coach Krzyzewski, as you look to see how can you consistently get into the top four of the conference, and you study the composition in terms of league recruiting, in terms of styles of play within a conference. Overpassing.
Yeah.
Can't overpass. That's taking a good shot and turning it into a bad play. An empty possession or turnover.
Dorsey under the rim. Ducks trying to extend what is their largest lead. But a foul sends the other way. That's on Benson.
The dribble handoff. But here, because he hands it off and moves, clearly he's got the pep and the step, the spring.
Missed the last game versus Stanford. He was in a walking boot, a sprained foot. Same foot he had surgery on over the summer after it was broken. A game time decision, and he's responded with 15 points, but only two since the break. Wide open underneath Bearfield. Knocked away.
Ennis able to use that length there to turn that appearing open shot into a contested shot by Bearfield.
So much for wide open. Of course, the Ducks leading the nation in block shots. Bell with authority.
Boy, they are working in concert. Two-man game basketball. A tandem or a pair that can read and react and have the skills to execute like this Duck team. It's pretty basketball.
Number 10 team of the country, the Oregon Ducks, starting to extend the lead. They're large for the night, 9. And glad to take a look at some highlights from this 13-2 Oregon run.
Well, Brooks sizing up, attacking the feet there of Kuzma from the elbow. And then in transition, the graceful 7-footer Boucher able to finish. And then Bell just starts to flex his muscle or his chest. Give him a cape. He's got the Superman or Batman performance going on. A superhero for the Ducks. Well, and he's taking shots that he knows he can make. So again, well deployed by Dana Altman and staff in terms of how they position their players to achieve success. Get them on the bus, right? Then you got to get them on the right seat. That's how you go good to great. It's actually a good book.
And Lav, if you're Coach Krzyzewski right now and you're in the huddle, you're trying to slow down this Ducks team, what do you do?
Well, it starts with defense. That helps. Get a bucket. Now you can set your defense.
On the other end, and it's quickly off the glass under the rim.
Well, and the second time we've seen the Ducks get opportunities, once by drawing a foul and there a basket, because of their ability to take the ball out of the net and take an opponent's basket away with one of their own. That's what the great Laker teams did, the Celtics. The best running teams, they run both off made and missed.
Kuzma with a good step and through. He's in double figures with 11.
Well, they almost did it again. Rare to get that 1-2 matchup. Compelling.
One hand slam. What a hammer from Bell.
My goodness. Again, we're going to have to check those rims.
15 now for Bell. Time to Brooks for a team high.
You know, the dunk, clearly an exclamation point, but really it was, again, the passing, the delivery there, the find. Daniels able to finish at the rim. The Utes have been rewarded when they go down low, either off the bounce for point blank shots or by feeding the bigs.
Under 10 minutes.
The point there was the dunk was spectacular, but it's fundamental basketball in terms of them finding the open man and playing together as a team.
And it's a teardrop with four to shoot. It's through. That's been 11 minutes. Peyton Pritchard, by the way, back on the floor now for the Ducks. We haven't seen him in some time with three fouls.
This is a critical sequence here. If the Utes can shave a couple points off this deficit, get to the timeout, regroup. And the Ducks playing through the hot hand. When you're throwing down as many jams, the variety, the style points. But again, it's set up by tight passing and perfect delivery. That's why Dana Altman has a successful program. The culture is built here. And it just continues to roll on in Eugene.
Now Kuzma, just a 64% free throw shooter, missing the front end of the one-and-one.
Ute's got to dig in, get a string of stops or shutouts. String together some good possessions at both ends of the floor. Allow this crowd to get back in the game.
Brooks stripped by Bearfield. He'll shoot.
Taking the clock down, they go to their best player in a little isolation against the smaller Bearfield. You've got the mouse in the house in terms of the mismatch in size that the Ducks can exploit.
Now you got to explain that one, Matt. A mismatch is mouse in the house?
That means someone smaller, diminutive. And if you've got big size, let's say a lumberjack, or in this case, a 6'7" Dylan Brooks, then your team needs to recognize when the mouse is in the house under the basket.
It sounds so simple. 16 for Brooks now.
Well, you have to teach with imagery and pictures and metaphor when dealing with 18 to 22-year-olds. It's a tough audience. Keep them captive.
Gillette back on the floor. He's playing with three fouls. And his controls, pushing.
Yeah, not much daylight at the rim against this long Duck team, and bottoms by Ennis. The Ducks hitting on all cylinders right now, both ends.
Gillette able to sneak it past Boucher.
And it's an important basket. Again, if they can get a stop and get it under double digits going into the 8-minute TV timeout, plenty of time.
Ennis, who has been such a better three-point shooter in conference play, taking this time all the way to the rim.
This has been textbook basketball offensively by the Ducks here.
Ennis now with 13. Foul going on Brooks, who flops to the deck.
Bearfield rewarded.
Oh, my.
You can't fault the Laurence Olivier, the Oscars, the theatrics. He has a flair for the dramatic with game-winning shots, or in that case, a flop.
That was spectacular.
He has fun on the floor, and the great ones have that. A childlike spirit. He's a great competitor, but also you can tell there's a joyfulness or a bounce to his game. And that's infectious or contagious. It rubs off on teammates as well.
Pritchard running into a roadblock, and Collette going back baseline. Bell, a rare miss. He's looking for a foul. And now a whistle on the baseline. Pritchard, his fourth foul.
Oregon alert and aggressive in this run, and using their length, their speed to provide resistance at the rim. Then offensively, the strength by Bell to finish. There's the Bearfield turnover, which leads to Boucher and his length, able to finish at the rim. Again, the Ducks web feet, but very quick when it comes to this attack. They are whacking. Don Henley, that was both a drummer and a vocalist, one
I
of
think
the
it
few.
It was absolutely Don Henley.
And it's tough to find, and the Eagles, right? You have those skills. Anyway.
9-point deficit. This is the chalk top.
Again, plenty of time inside of double digits now. Guaranteed. Coach Kostowiak talked about the defense. Too many easy looks at the rim for the Ducks.
Gillette on Bell. Gillette spills.
And give the Ducks an angle to the rim. That's one stop. Now you convert. Here it's pivotal. They play through the paint. Get a touch for the bigs.
Fifth Oregon turnover. Counter that to 13 for Utah.
There it is.
Kuzma gets Boucher up in the air and capitalizes. Just what you called for. Team high 13 for Kuzma. And now the crowd gets back into this one.
Got to dig in one more time. Provide resistance at the rim.
Brooks rising. Brooks rattles out. Daniels waltzes it across the timeline.
You can attack off the bounce or tough pass there.
Try to thread the needle.
Well, again, these are judgments or decisions that are costly. Such an important possession. I'm not sure Roberto Clemente could have picked that one up.
That was a point-blank fastball. 14th Utah turnover. Fairfield picks Vincent's pocket. Fairfield lays it in. 5-point game. 8-0 run in less than 2 minutes for the Utes. And suddenly 15,000 in a frenzy. Brooks taking it against Collette.
Making amends for the earlier turnover, gets one back in a critical situation for his team, and able to finish. Hard fall to the ground, and then Brooks, the crossover, the gather with one bounce, able to take it from 26 feet out to the rim, and that's efficient use of the bounce.
Brooks, beloved here in Utah, gets the Collette leading the way with four for Utah. Peyton Pritchard with four. Boucher and Bell with three for Oregon.
My sense is Collette will not be on the bench for very long, given the significance of this game and his maturity and experience, his skill set. Two-way player when you look at Collette.
Brooks now a game-high 18. Fairfield gets it back in the corner, rises for the three. Turns out to essentially be an alley-oop to Kuzma. Way back to five for Oregon. Boucher, what a slam! Wingspan, Chris Boucher.
And great basketball. Utes switched again, mouse in the house, mismatch. Boucher recognized instead of shooting a jumper, he takes it to the hole and flushes home.
Utah, how about this for another look?
Well, good recognition. There was the switch, Kuzma and Fairfield. The Ducks again, NBA flavor, see that.
Three attempts short. And it slows it down. We approach the 5 minute mark.
There have been sequences where the Utes settle for jumpers here, a breakdown defensively. They're fortunate.
Boucher trying to save it to Brooks with a head of steam. And is fighting with Daniels.
High ball screen. Explore or probe the paint and post feeds. Give yourself a chance to get fouled along the way and get to the free throw line.
Brooks thinking about it. One versus Kuzma, deep two. Bell bats it away, controlled by Oregon. They wanted a walk, Boucher wanted a foul. Daniels given space by Dorsey.
Yeah, ill-advised shot again when Coach Kostowiak goes back, watches game film with his boys. They'll talk about the value of every possession, the razor-thin margin for where you play with in college basketball, and in particular against the Oregon Ducks.
Utah has missed 7 of 9 three attempts in the second half. They went for Bell, but it's picked by Bonham. Daniels, two half flush. Lab, both teams still shooting over 50%. Both teams with at least half their points coming in the paint, and part of the reason why we've seen a lot of play above the rim.
Well, attack the cup, attack the rim, and you'll be rewarded. Aggressive moves to the basket. Two-man basketball with the pick and roll. The foot speed of this Oregon team, in particular the front line, is exceptional. You see it there with Boucher off the bounce. Then Utah going to get some of their own transition basketball, defense grading offense. Daniels, the jam.
Oregon in the midst of a program record 16 consecutive wins. Utah, even Steven, 2-2 their last four games against top 10 opponents. Dylan Brooks now with 18, a game high. Remember this Ducks offense going right into the teeth of this Utah student section in the second half.
Yeah, man and zone. They've been able to get into the interior. They've screened both man and zone defenses as well effectively.
Five to shoot for Dorsey. Cross it over. Stepping through. Taking on Kuzma. How about that finish?
Tyler Dorsey, a cool customer. Maneuvers well off the bounce. Plays at a pace where he's under control. There again, the size of Dorsey allowed him to finish over the top. Aaron.
Only 4 points for Dorsey, former McDonald's All-American, but a timely bucket that time.
Something here for the Utes going to the rim.
Collette lowered his head. Backdoor Kuzma. Under. Can't finish.
It was a good idea. Good two-man basketball. Just came up short.
Oregon a chance to stretch this lead to double figures. Brooks backdoor. Picked by Van Dyke. Left his feet without a plan. And Van Dyke loses it. Flops on top. Bottom controlling. Under 2.5 minutes. Van Dyke with Dennis in front. Kuzma trying to follow. They get into the hands of Dorsey. Utes looking for that signature win. Only one win against a top 100 RPI team. That's USC.
Don't want to wait too long and end up with a bad shot. Elbows in your tonsils.
The three to shoot in his front iron. Here comes Bonham. Kuzma, tough three. Kuzma buries it. Timeout called by Utah. Then Kyle Kuzma. Twice he thought Kuzma would crack and transfer.
And that says a lot if he was harder on him than any player because, as you know, Coach Kostowiak, a tough customer, kind of a great Santini approach to his coaching.
Dividends paid out from Kuzma this year especially. Dorsey puts on the brakes. Brooks pulls up. And Kuzma with an emphatic rebound.
Don't need the three ball.
Collette in transition. Oh, my goodness. Pritchard back on the floor with four fouls for Oregon.
1 minute remaining in the game.
Full Ford style with North Carolina. Pre-shot clock. Dean Smith years in Chapel Hill.
Well, now four to shoot. Brooks deep and straight away. UConn's got to get the ball back, and they do. One timeout left. Oregon with two. Bonham ahead of steam. Offensive foul!
Boy, Utes feeling like they can't get a break here. Again, love to see that as a no-call as a coach in this situation. Now, it is true, there was the arm. Did it extend? It wasn't a red grain. It wasn't, you know, an extended forearm shiver. It was more of an armbar guarding, where you guard the ball with that armbar. But again, I'm very biased as a basketball coach.
That would have been Pritchard's fifth. Home run pass to Brooks over his head, and Utah gets it right back.
Just get the ball in bounds. Instead, they go for the home run play. Like a fly pattern to the end zone. Turn it over, they'll come back this way. And now, what's critical about that turnover is the Utes, who are effective at their baseline out-of-bounds execution, get the ball where they prefer.
And how about this? Rawson coming on. Collette couldn't come back in because the clock never started. The ball was never touched.
That's a tough break if you're a Utes fan. It's like goal line defense here for the Ducks.
Van Dyke. Short, right in Kuzma's lap. No foul called. Boucher and Bell went up with it. And Ennis losing it. The clock has not started.
Need a new engineer when it comes to the shot clock here in Salt Lake. But I thought up high clean, but my question was down low. The body was their contact between Boucher. Tough was somewhat blocked with that camera angle. Again, Utes going for another three, but Kuzma able to secure the ball.
5 seconds ran off before the clock stops.
You see the clock.
So 9 seconds is what needs to be changed. And it was 23.8 left. Bell to inbounds. In Pritchard's hands. Pressure from Van Dyke and a foul.
Their defense, you don't get a steal fouling in this game. And Oregon went on a run. There was also the Kuzma layup that he turned down and passed when he had a layup himself and led to a turnover. And then that Collette missed free throw.
Bottom trying to hurry, taking on Boucher.
And like this is a report card. Make adjustments with the staff, do the teaching with the team on the floor and the drill work.
Zamora checks back in. A 42% three-point shooter. It's the second.
Don't get the steal, but foul right now.
At Colorado, then on FS1 against the Sun Devils, and then against the top team of the conference, Sean Miller's Wildcats, at Pauley Pavilion against UCLA, and then at USC, who just took down the Bruins. How about that schedule, Renee?
And the amazing thing, because the Ducks are playing at such a high level, as you see Brooks miss a free throw, they can win all five of those games, have a chance to win four. And even if you go 3-2, you're still in good shape, given the competitive nature of this league. But if Oregon plays like this, they'll have a chance to win every one of those games.
Van Dyke, a three in the corner. Pritchard trying to control on the ground. Loose ball controlled by Boucher. And the Ducks survive. They led for all of a minute in the first half. And Dana Altman of the number 10 team of the country continues to extend its program's all-time winning streak to 17 games.
Well, we saw two well-coached teams, well-prepared teams. Oregon right now hitting on all cylinders, a well-oiled machine with their sights set on a conference championship, a one seed in the NCAA tournament, has a tough schedule coming up. And the Utes, I really feel, Aaron, they are a team come February that no one will want to play, and by the time they get to conference tournament, will be capable of cutting down the nets.
The Oregon defense holding its 19th of 21 opponents under 70 points again this season. Too much Dylan Brooks, too much Jordan Bell, as the Ducks survive in Salt Lake City. Once again, our final score, Oregon 73, Utah 67. For Steve Lavin, our entire FS1 crew, I'm Aaron Goldsman. Glad you could join us here tonight in Utah. Coming up next.